You got a little mess right here, don't you? A little mess right here, don't you? Yeah, cause we know how three gets his gains.
This McDonald's. You know, a lot of people don't like McDonald's right now. Make sure you make your first
one. Speaking of McDonald's, man, what do you got to say to the naysayers that tell you you need to leave your double cheeseburgers on?
Look at me. That shit don't mean nothing, baby. that's a myth.
Mythbusters.
Yeah.
Yo, hold on. We need to do 30 days.
What,
30
days of what?
Like, what dude did? Supersize me?
Nah, hell no.
Yeah, you mean?
Remy, you lazy as hell. Yep. Raise it up. Oh, you can. That's a workout right there. Get it. Come on. Look at that arm, though. And boom. Out here with your gym. Outside. With your gym. We gotta work on that trampoline though.
Outside with your gym.
Good job, Yig.
But me and the alpha male do when we're not in the gym. A lot of people be like, oh, what do you guys do? You guys can't possibly be in the gym all the time. And we don't. We take some days off, but it's really not. We take days off from the gym, but we do stuff at the house.
Yeah, so understand. Now, no days off.
Exactly. So now y'all get a sneak peek of what we do at the crib.
This man, like he back on the yard somewhere.
You gonna give me fired from my job? You say back on the yard?
Huh?
Back yard.
Oh, okay, there you go.
I'm about to get you in there. 10 reps, 10 push-ups, sprint back, 10 push-ups, 10 reps.
All right. We often don't want to boast about ourselves. We think it's in a general sense wrong. But if you're not going to pat yourself on the back, who will? Besides your parents wanting you to do well for yourself, there's not many people who do. I know siblings who feel jealousy amongst each other. Fortunately, I have a sister that's not like this, but it's more rare than you think. See, you want other people to do it for you. You're waiting on this external, and you train yourself to not feel good about yourself until you get a guy or a girl to tell you you're cute, or until you get X amount of followers on Instagram, where your boss says good job on that presentation, or your teachers say great job, here's an A, or your spouse praises you. And most often, I see this underwhelming belief in themselves in clients who are humble. And they're amazing people, but they don't really feel it in their core, the amazing qualities they're made of, because they don't hear enough praise. And the reality is that the external world isn't gonna praise you all that much. So you really need to do it for yourself. And the clients I work with rarely ever do that. They show humility, not to brag. But in a way, they're proud to be humble. But did you catch me there? Proud of being humble. It's an oxymoron. It's a contradictory statement. Humility should come naturally without expecting a reward from it, not feeling proud about it. but you should always be confident about yourself. You have to trust yourself. You have to praise yourself. Some of you celebrate teams where you don't know one guy on the team personally, and you do it hundreds of times more than you celebrate your own accomplishment. When was the last time you went nuts for something going on in your life? Stand up and jump up in the air right now. Give yourself a round of applause. And I tell my clients often to do this one exercise. Go to the mirror and look at yourself in the mirror and say, I love you. I love you, and then say your name at the end of it. And when they do it at first, often they can barely even look at themselves in the eye as they do it. They look away, they drift away, and it takes like dozens of times of saying it until they say it and look at themselves dead on in the eye. The two biggest assets you need in life are confidence in your ability to improve and trust in yourself that you can handle any moment that comes your way. If you have those two assets, you're golden. And you're like, well, I don't want to be arrogant. And I'm not asking you to be arrogant. I'm asking you to believe in yourself. What's the difference between confidence and arrogance? Arrogance is rubbing it into other people to make them feel bad about themselves. Confidence is believing in your abilities and being able to back them up. Let me share a story with you. It's national championships. Right after weigh-ins, the tournament started, and a stud wrestler from Navy passes me in the hall during warm-ups, and he looks at me and he goes, nods his head, and he says, I'll see you in the finals. And I was like, whoa, wow, this kid is bold. We've got like six rounds to go. I didn't say anything. I just was like shocked. I was seated number 2 in the tourney. He was seated number 8. And during the year, I beat him 3 times during the year, and I beat him 2 weeks prior to in the regional finals. And if you know wrestling, to beat someone 3 times in one season is really hard, especially when you're really close. But you know what happened? He became natty champ. I wasn't. I lost in the semifinals. He met his end of the bargain. And when he said it with this utmost confidence. Like he really, truly just believed it. Like, I will see you in the finals. Because he had faith that I would get there too. And he knew that he was going to knock out the number 1 seed. And he did in the quarterfinals. And me, I wavered. Right? And you know what? It showed. In the semifinals when I wrestled another stud wrestler. It showed. And I lost by a couple of points. I didn't fully believe in the moment. And I wrestled back and took 3rd. But I know I was really the best wrestler in that weight class. But I didn't show up. And you know what? Just that little tiny mentality is all the difference in the world. If you've ever been in the zone before, you know that you just total confidence in your ability. And I didn't have that day, right? But I was waiting on this external for it to just appear, not out of nowhere. And you know what? It's an internal trigger. You can trigger at any moment, and you have to do it. Did Arnold go on stage and say, I think I'm going to win? Absolutely not. He talked about this in Pumping Iron. He knew it in his core. He just knew it. I will win no matter what. And that confidence just emanates off as energy. Muhammad Ali used to say, I'm the greatest, over and over again. And everyone thought it was cocky, right? But he backed it up. He's rated as probably the best heavyweight of all time. And years after fighting was over, he explained it and said, I told myself that over and over again, so eventually I would believe it. When you express it, it gets ingrained in your subconscious. You actually believe it. You really do. These thoughts become power. These words become power. You need to believe in yourself. Because if you don't, who will?
Success, guys, is a very, very lonely road, man. Very few people are willing to endure the pain, the sacrifice, the due diligence to be successful. It's an uphill battle. And along that road, you're not gonna see too many friends. You're gonna see your shadow most often. You gotta trust in the heart of hearts, inside what you're doing, what you believe in, is a worthy cause, a winnable fight. See, the thing is, for many people, they've tried the same path you're on, and they failed. As you walk this journey, you're gonna see carcasses all over the place of people that didn't quite have it. That should inspire you, because you've gotten further than that person, than that person. But you're not looking to get further than them, you're looking to finish. How do you know you're on the right path? Where do you go to ensure that? Do you talk to your neighbor? No, you don't talk to him. I'll tell you about the neighbor, guys. That neighbor's gonna come in, man, and if you're a little chubby, a little overweight, you'd be like, hey, man, I'm thinking about doing a routine, man, or getting a training program where I lose some weight. He's gonna encourage you at first. He's like, yeah, you should. Basically insulting your ass, and you are fat, and you need to lose some weight. It's never support, it's negative shit. Oh, you should lose some weight. So you take his advice, and you start training, you start doing something, you start to get in shape a little bit, maybe at his level. Then all of a sudden, he's gonna start asking questions, his tone's gonna shift, especially as you get in better shape than him. Then he's gonna start talking shit. Because what happens now, guys, is that your success is like a spotlight shining down on their missed opportunities. Success, many will love you for it. The majority will hate you. Because your success makes them feel insufficient in their current endeavor, reminds them of where they could have done it, but they came up short, and how they didn't revisit it. Where they went at and failed, and failure is what stood. They never revisited it again. The difference between a winner and a loser, the failure is there every single time. It's just the winner gets back up and does it again, until it goes his way. So now you're down that path and you're all alone. How do you know you're on the right path? How do you know what you're doing is in the right direction? If you're wondering if you're on the right path, look at the small things of life. How do you do them? When you wash your car, you spend an hour washing your car, and you finish washing, you put the hoses and everything away and the brushes, and you come outside to look at the job you did, but you notice the spot's missing. What do you do? Do you re-grab the hose and pull it all out and finish the job right, or do you say, you know, that's good enough? And it's good enough. Because the thing about good enough is we don't know if it's enough. Until the nth hour, the final hour, and everything's on the line, that's when we find out if it is enough. And if we come up short, man, doesn't that suck? I promise you guys, if today you never say good enough, tomorrow you'll always have enough. What I'm saying is a character of who you are. It's not the title that makes you, it's not the success that makes you. The character defines the success, defines the fame, and it starts right there. Championships aren't won in the theater of the arena. They're won in the thousands of hours in the training room, in the labs, in the 5 a.m. runs, and when it's raining, when everyone else is sleeping. That's when it's won. The heart of a champion is a light switch that's always on. It doesn't go on and off when someone's watching. It's constant. It's how you look at something, if your name's attached to it, that you do it right, the best of your ability every single time. If you're dusting your countertops, do you dust around the picture frame, or do you pick the up and dust the entire thing? Do the job right or don't do it at all. That's the same person who has his hand raised on the podium one day. Same motherfuckers. How you hold yourself in the small things of life, build the character winning blocks of the things that we'll remember for. I see them as one and one the same, guys. It begins right now with no one looking, man. And how you hold yourself, how you see yourself. What do you do when no one's watching? If you do it then, I guarantee you, you'll be doing.
It's dark out, baby. Nice sky shot. Nice sky shot. You hit the chest pressing out. Yo, can you get that diamond on? Oh, get the diamond. Get the diamond. Can you see the diamond? Can you see the diamond? Can you see the diamond?
Yeah, baby.
Let him out. Let him out. Let him out. Good pump.
Is he dying? Can he die? Can he die?
Representing the mighty Madhouse Muscle.
100%. Representing Madhouse Muscle. Madhouse Muscle Physiques.
Yo, we outside late night getting it in. See, when we say no days off, we literally mean no days off. Like, days off, taking a risk, that's from the gym. But when I'm home, I still hit something. Because guess what? That's the difference between a champion and somebody who wants to be a winner. Somebody who complains and somebody who trains. See, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna work when ain't nobody looking. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be at home making those gains when everybody is asking how, everybody asking why. I'm gonna be at home putting the change in for that man in the mirror.
And this is just a video just to show you guys what you can do at home. And like my cousin said, there's no excuse. And we sneaky with our workouts. Like, this is one guy out there. He know who he is.
Shots fired.
He said to me, I guess I wasn't putting up videos or pictures of me in the gym. And it was just funny because he was like, yo, you don't need to work out no more. And I always work out, whether it's in the house. You don't have to be in the gym, but we sneaky with it. So that's why every time you see us on the street, Walmart, the movie theaters, the mall, because we always get it.
Hold on. You see the diamond? Do you see the diamond? You see the diamond?
Go ahead, Alpha.
Yo. That's basically it. We're going to wrap right there.
They ain't fucking with us.